अस्सलाम वालेकुम, हेलो गाइस। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द इंडिकेटेड वर्क पर ऑटो साइकिल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। हियर यू कैन सी द ऑटो साइकिल इन विच द इनटेक कंप्रेशन एक्सपेंशन एंड द एग्जॉस्ट रॉक्स आर शोन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज द इंडिकेटेड वर्क पर साइकिल? द इंडिकेटेड वर्क पर साइकिल इज एक्चुअली द वर्क डन बाय द इंजन ओवर द कंप्रेशन एंड द एक्सपेंशन स्ट्रोक्स एज शोन बाय दिस इक्वेशन। The indicated work per cycle is equal to the work done during the compression plus the work done during the expansion, and it is shown on the PV diagram by this area A, which is called the power loop. As the name refers, the power loop consists of the main power, the main work done by the engine, which will eventually store in the flywheel to run the automobile. So here you can see two additional strokes in this real auto cycle, the intake stroke and the exhaust stroke. So the work during the intake stroke to induce the air fuel mixture into the cylinder by the piston, and the work during the exhaust stroke to remove the burnt gases out of the engine is called the pumping work. And this diagram, this area B, refers to the pumping loop. So what is the pumping loop? The pumping loop is actually the energy, some of the energy from this gross indicated work, which will utilize to induce the air fuel mixture into the engine and to remove the burnt gases out of the engine. So the new definition from the indicated work, the net indicated work. Net indicated work is equal to the gross indicated work, which is the main power loop of your engine, the total energy of your engine in easy words, minus the pumping work. The pumping work is the work done during the intake stroke and the exhaust stroke. So what does it mean? Your whole power is the power loop, and the power loop minus the pumping loop is actually your net indicated work per cycle, per cylinder of the IC engine. So next, the indicated work is directly proportional to the power produced by the engine. By this relation, power of the engine is equal to indicated work per cycle. You can use the value here, the gross or the net. It depends on the calculations. The calculations level. So the power is equal to indicated work into the RPMs of the engine and the NR factor. The NR factor is the number of rotations of the crank per power stroke of the engine. As I am referring to the 4-stroke engine, so NR is equal to 2. It means after 2 crank rotations, there will be 1 power stroke in 4-stroke cycle engine, and in 2-stroke engine NR is equal to 1. So now let's talk about the pumping loop and how to get rid of the by this. So here I have two major cases: an engine with no turbocharger, a naturally aspirated engine PV diagram, and an engine with a turbocharger or a supercharger. So here let's focus on the naturally aspirated engine. In naturally aspirated engine, or in any engine, there are certain throttle positions, there is some part loading. The engine and the car is not always running at its top speed, so there are different throttle positions. Here I have two extremes for the naturally aspirated engines. In the first condition, the throttle is fully closed or near to close, in which the inlet manifold pressure will be the most vacuum pressure, and the obviously the air fuel mixture is entering at pressure atmospheric in naturally aspirated engine. So the DP, the pressure difference, will be maximum, and there will be the most vacuum region in the intake manifold. So the piston here in the cylinder has to do more work in order to induce the air fuel mixture into the cylinder. And on the other hand, there is a wide open throttle case, in which the DP is the least, in which the air fuel mixture in the manifold, intake manifold, has the least vacuum. So in this case, the piston has to do least work in order to intake the air fuel mixture. So according to these two extremes, the pumping loop here will be the largest, the highest, and in this case will be the smallest. But you cannot get rid of the pumping loop in naturally aspirated engine completely. You cannot completely get rid of the pumping loop for this case, because there are other certain positions of throttle, and according to these throttle positions, your pumping loop here will be varying. So how to get rid of this pumping loop completely? For this, we have a turbocharged or a supercharged cars. In turbocharged cars, what is happening? We are using the energy of the exhaust gases, which are way above this atmospheric pressure. As you can see, the exhaust is above the PATM. So there is much energy in the exhaust gases. We utilize this energy and it will energize the intake air, and then our intake stroke will be above atmospheric pressure. What I am saying is, the pressure here will no longer be atmospheric pressure. In the turbocharged case, the pressure here will way above the atmospheric pressure, and then there is no longer the vacuum here, and actually the air fuel mixture will do the work on the piston during the intake stroke. So it will be beneficial for us that it will adding energy to our system and not taking energy from the system. So that's how in the turbocharged case we can get rid of the pumping loop completely, or you can say nearly completely. So that's how the indicated work per cycle, the pumping loops phenomena, is working in naturally aspirated engine and the turbocharged engine. So now it's time for the fact of the day. So if you guys have any questions, you can comment below. I'll try to answer them. And don't forget to subscribe, share, and like this video. So until next, bye-bye.